shall reflect on the life of Saint Basil the Great. Saint Basil comes from a remarkable holy family. Very early, Basil exhibited a serious and studious character and a brilliant mind. He studied letters at Caesarea, rhetoric and philosophy at Constantinople, and astronomy, geometry and medicines at Athens. But it was his saintly sister Macrina who turned his mind from worldly knowledge to the spiritual. Basil travelled through Syria, Palestine, Mesopotamia and Egypt to visit the flourishing colonies of monks and hermits there, and on his return led the eremitical life for 5 years. But numerous followers kept attaching themselves to him, so that he finally founded a monastic colony on his family property in Pontus and composed for them the famous rule of Saint Basil, which gained rapid acceptance everywhere and made him the father of Eastern monasticism. He was ordained priest in 364 by Archbishop Eusebius of Caesarea, to whom, by his eminent sanctity and profound learning, combined with a great gift for organization and administration, he gradually became indispensable. 6 years later, he was elected to succeed Eusebius. It is said that over half of Asia Minor, with 11 provinces, came under his influence, and it was due to Saint Basil's intrepid and calm opposition to every Arianizing effort of Emperor Valens and his court that all Cappadocia remained true to the faith. Both clergy and laity were held to do so faithful an observance of the canons, and the priests were selected so carefully and trained so strictly that the diocese became a model to all. His concern for the destitute led Basil to establish poor houses in various districts of the diocese. There were also shops where unskilled workers could receive technical training. Basil himself practiced the Christian precept of poverty and continued to live in ascetic austerity. Saint Basil, who is the patron of Russia and of hospital administrators, is numbered among the greatest figures in the history of the Church. The Greeks venerate him as one of the three great ecumenical doctors. Outstanding among his doctrinal writings is his famous work on the Holy Spirit, which still remains unsurpassed.